Welcome back to the U Sports Report, guys. It's Tuesday, so you know that means we have a brand new episode for you. I'm Kimberly Temple, and alongside me today is Tyler Ortega, the dab master. And unfortunately, Cam Newton won't be dabbing next year. How do you feel about that?
That's fine. That's totally okay with me. I mean, first off, Cam didn't even invent the dab, so he kind of bit it off from some rappers, Migos. I don't know if the public out there is familiar with them. Probably not. But the dab will live forever, whether Cam's doing it or not.
Well, then Tyler will remain our dab master, which is good news for everybody. So the NHL finals came to a screeching halt when Pittsburgh beat San Jose in Game 6, which I'm not happy about.
Yeah, I was going to say, I know that's much to your dismay. However, the Sharks did put up a good fight.
They did.
For what it's worth.
They did. And we have some highlights for you guys here on Around the Nation. Pittsburgh did, I mean, they played 6 games total in this series. San Jose forced for a game 6. Obviously, here we're honoring the late, great Gordie Howe, Mr. Hockey. Both teams just utterly dismayed by the loss of such an amazing athlete. Someone that we will never forget, Tyler.
Yeah, I mean, we obviously did not have the privilege to see him play, but his impact on the sport was just monumental. You know, a true Iron Man of the NHL.
He did not retire until he was 52 years old, which is impressive. But here the Sharks and the Pittsburgh are, the Penguins and the Sharks. This was an amazing series, I think, for the Sharks because it tested their endurance in a lot of ways. We saw Joe Pavelski make some major plays, but we saw a lot of other Sharks players step it up. Couture right there just scored the first goal for the Sharks in the game. Game 6 against the Penguins.
Yeah, and when the Sharks beat the LA Kings in the first round, that, you know, honestly shocked me. And once they did that, you know, I had the feeling they could go all the way. However, they ran into this buzzsaw juggernaut that is the Pittsburgh Penguins with Sidney Crosby, Evgeny Malkin. There you see Sidney Crosby. They have Letang there as well. Pittsburgh just loaded with star power.
They are. And, you know, earlier on in the regular season, Pittsburgh wasn't looking all that great. I honestly was pretty impressed with them more so in the playoffs than I was in the regular season, which makes a lot of sense, but they really stepped up onto their A game and pushed every team that they played against to their ultimate limits, the Sharks included. Sharks defense was not there at all. This play by Pavelski, incredible, right behind the back of the goalie, but unfortunately not into the goal box.
That's incredible, just to get that angle and not be able to finish it. And here you see Malkin should have tucked that one away, but superior goalkeeping there by the Sharks.
Third period, here's the Stanley Cup, the ultimate prize for any NHL player, team, coach, staff, anyone. The Sharks have never won a Stanley Cup in the 25 years of team history. This is their first time going this far in the playoffs also, Tyler.
You know, it would have been nice to see them get it on their first time. However, Pittsburgh, they're saying, you guys got to pay your dues.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, Pittsburgh, it's been 7 years since they got a Stanley Cup, and they have definitely worked to have earned it this year. I have nothing but respect for the Pittsburgh Penguins, although I am obviously greatly saddened by the loss. I'm impressed with the Sharks going as far as they did and working as hard as they did to make this series last.
Absolutely, and I mean, it came literally down to the wire here. As you see, there's an open net with about a minute to go. Had San Jose been able to score that, they would have forced overtime, potentially forced a game 7. However, that was the dagger, and that's it for the San Jose Sharks.
Disappointing loss for San Jose, incredible win for the Penguins. Nothing but respect, like I said. I'm thoroughly impressed with these NHL playoffs altogether.
Yeah, and you know, what you like to see is, as you do in every single sport, is the big players step up on big stages. Now, we haven't seen that in the NBA Finals, which we'll get to in just a second, but Sidney Crosby's impact on this series was just monumental.
Yes.
You know, he earned that title of best player in the world.
He really did. And, you know, I couldn't have named a better player this season and on any NHL team than Sidney Crosby, who was absolutely dominated in the game of hockey.
Maybe Alexander Ovechkin, however, we saw how that series shook out between the Caps and the Pens. But Sidney Crosby, hats off to you, sir. You well-deserved Stanley Cup, his second of his career.
Yes, and that's an impressive thing to have on his career, on his resume, so to say.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, moving along, NBA Finals, we were just telling you, we're gonna show you games 5 and 6 since we missed you guys last Thursday. Here we go, game 5, Golden State at Cleveland. Now, Cleveland in the hole, 2-1 in this one. So they're trying to save this series just a little bit. Kyrie with the miss, LeBron with a monster follow-up, and LeBron James was dialed in this one. Klay Thompson from downtown, no good. Big board straight to Steph, who's able to follow it up. Now it's a 6-point game, about halfway through the fourth quarter, no good. Iguodala, huge rebound. Harrison Barnes, give me all three of those.
Beautiful game on both teams' behalf. You know, I'm really impressed with LeBron's ability to not only step it up, you expect big things from LeBron, but to really dominate for his team and do as much as he possibly can against the Golden State Warriors.
Well, that's why he is the best player in the world. And here, this is what everybody was talking about over the past few days. Draymond Green, LeBron James, things getting a little testy between them. LeBron decides to step over Draymond, which prompts a low blow, which they did call a flagrant. Draymond would be suspended for game 6. You see the two having to be separated here, and you see LeBron getting a little frustrated. It's odd to see LeBron, a player of his caliber, lose his cool. Steph Curry's like, come on, man. Come on.
I saw a lot of memes about this picture right there. LeBron asking Steph, could I just come to Golden State? But I don't think LeBron has any intentions of that move at all. Steph and LeBron and Draymond, all some palpable tension.
So Cleveland lost game 5 there at home. They're taking out game 6 going on last night out in Oakland at the Oracle.
This is game 5.
This is game 5, excuse me.
We showed you game 4
game
before.
Game 4, yeah, my bad. But Kyrie just came to play. Kyrie and LeBron James both scored 41 as you see LeBron getting in the paint and one, count the bucket.
You know, I have a question for you, Tyler. I've read some articles saying that if Draymond is to completely clean up his game and not be as intense, for a lack of a better word, as he has been in his entire career, he won't be exactly the same player that he is. How do you feel about that?
No, I think that's absolutely correct. It's his tenacity that really makes him what he is, his scrappiness. He's not afraid to get in there and bang with the big boys. You see, he's talking to LeBron James like he's his little brother. You know, Draymond, I mean, he respects the guys. However, he's not scared of anybody. And that's what Golden State needs. Every team needs that enforcer, which Draymond unfortunately got suspended for. Yeah. But he'll be back on Thursday night, game 6. That one should be a good one.
Yeah, that'll be an exciting game. And, you know, I think if Draymond even just a tad bit cleans it up and puts on that tenacity in a positive way for his team, we're going to see some big things in the remainder of his career and Golden State's remainder of this series. But I'm interested because the series is getting a little more close. It's going to be a difficult remainder of the series.
It definitely will. And honestly, I think Cleveland will win game 6 at home. They know this is potentially their very last, or it is their last home game of the season. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't want Golden State to win the title on Cleveland's floor like they did last year in game 6. So this could be a carbon copy of what we just saw last June. However, Andrew Bogut sustained a wicked knee injury last night. Yeah. We're waiting to see. They pushed the MRI back to today from last night. So that's encouraging. Hopefully just a small hyperextension, something like that. But I do think Cleveland wins game 6, but I think Golden State will close it out game 7.
There you go, guys. Golden State taking it in game 7. So that's going to take all of that we have for the Around the Nation segment. But stay tuned because Tyler and I are going to wrap about some college sports. And there's a lot to talk about.
National champs.
Yeah, some big, big news for UNM and New Mexico.